will come for the operation of the differential amplifier. So what happens the operation of differential amplifier? What we are going to see in the operation of differential amplifier. So the operation of the differential amplifier says that, as we have seen, there are two gains. So one is AD and the one is an AC. What is AD? Differential gain. What is AC? Common mode gain. That means this differential amplifier works with two different operations. See, so every amplifier works with only with one operation thing, but this differential amplifier, as it contains two gains, that means it works with two different operations. So one is differential mode operation. That means in a differential mode operation, we will provide two different inputs. So whenever we provide two different inputs for two different transistors, so there exists differential mode operation. So whenever we provide a similar inputs, that means equal inputs for the both the transistors, so we will provide common mode. So we are going to see or analyze this differential amplifier, the operation of the differential amplifier in two different mode of operations. So one is differential mode operation and the one is common mode operation. Now we will come for differential mode operation. So what is meant by differential mode operation? Already we have seen earlier, I have said earlier, what is differential mode operation? Differential mode operation means it contains two different input signals. So these are circuit. So it should provide with two different input signals. That means V1 should not be equal to V2. So first case, when we will say that V1 signal is equal to V2, when both the magnitudes and phase of V1 and V2 are equal, then only we can say that V1 is equal to V2. That means 4. If V1 is equal to 4 and V2 is also is equal to 4, then we can say that V1 equal to V2. If V1 is equal to 4 and if we provide V2 is equal to minus 4, then we can't say that V1 equal to V2, because these are equal in magnitude but opposite in phase. One is a positive phase and the one is a negative phase. So for our simplification purpose, we won't take two different values for V1 and V2. We will consider a single value which is equal in magnitude but opposite in phase for our simplification purpose. So for that I used a center taper transformer. So what is the importance of center taper transformer? So this center taper transformer produces two signals which are equal in magnitude but opposite in phase, so for our simplification purpose only. So I am using a center taper transformer. So as it is a differential mode operation, the two inputs should be different. So for that case, I am using a center taper transformer. It provides two inputs which are in equal in magnitude but opposite in phase. So here, say that. So from this center taper transformer, I got a signal with a positive and negative at time period. And here I got a signal with a negative and positive signal. Now I have provided these inputs for two transistors Q1 and Q2. So as I already said, the two transistors which we are using here, Q1 and Q2, should be equal, should be matched with each other. What is going to be matching? The properties of Q1 should be equal to properties of Q2. So whenever the properties of both the transistors are equal, if we provide same inputs for both the transistors, the amplification process is also same. That means if you provide 2 as an input, the output will be a 4 or 6 by amplification, 4, 6, 7. In the same way, if you also provide this Q2, 2 volts for this Q2, the amplification, if it amplifies 4, it also amplifies 4. So if you provide minus 2 here, if it amplifies with 2, it also amplifies with 2. So this is the meaning of matching transistor. That means the amplification process will be same for both the transistors. Now we will come for operation. So before going to discuss about the operation of this differential mode operation, we have to see the operation of CE amplifier. So what the CE amplifier says? In a CE amplifier, we see that there will be a 180 degrees phase shift between input and output. That means if the input is positive going signal, output will be negative going signal. So in a CE amplifier, there will be a 180 degrees phase shift between input and output. So this operation helps us to take the operation of an differential mode operation. So now we will see. So as I use a center taper transformer, so here I got a plus and minus signal, and here I got a minus and plus signal, negative and positive going signal. So as I provided for Q1, so first we will see. So this signal travels to collector as well as it also travels to emitter, because emitter, collector and base are interconnected with each other, as we all know the operations of transistor. So IC, the collector current IC is equal to beta times of IB, and we can take IC is approximately equal to IE. That means IE is also will be a beta times of IB. That means IE and IC are, IB, IC and IB are interconnected with each other. So as we provide a base current, automatically that base current travels to a emitter and it also travels to a collector with an amplified version, with an amplified version. So in a CE amplifier, there will be a phase shift between input and output. So if it is an input, the collector is an output. So there will be a phase shift between input and output. That means if it is a positive going signal, then we get a negative going signal. But whereas for base and emitter, the signals will be in phase. What is meant by in phase? If it is a positive going signal, here it also will be a positive going signal. If it is a negative going signal, here it also will be a negative going signal. So for the base of Q1, as I provided a positive and negative going signal, and for the emitter also, it provides only positive and negative going, because these two will be in phase. These two will be in phase. So as these both these two things are in phase, so the same signal comes here, but with an amplified version. Here also the same thing happens. So here I provided a negative and the positive going signal. So this signal comes here. As these two things are in phase, so here also we get a negative and positive going signal. So these two signals are traveling in the same direction. So they two get with adds with each other. Whenever these two signals adds with each other, so if here it is a plus 4, it will be a minus 4 here. So if it is a plus 4, here it will be a minus 4. So plus 4 and minus 4 becomes 0. That means it says that in a differential mode operation, that means whenever we provide a different inputs for different transistors, in a differential mode operation, there will not be any signal flowing through RE. There will not be any signal flowing through RE. So the signal flowing through RE acts as a feedback. So we all know that if A is the gain of an amplifier without feedback, and AF is the gain of an amplifier with feedback, definitely A will be greater than AF. That means the gain with feedback decreases the gain without feedback. So the gain with feedback will be lesser when compared to gain without feedback. But here we see that in a differential mode operation, there is no signal flowing through RE. That means there is no signal which is going as a feedback. So the gain in a differential mode operation is known as AD. So as there is no feedback, that means the gain will not be decreased. So the AD value will be very high. And here we see that there is no signal flowing through RE. So in a differential mode operation, we will neglect RE. There is no use of RE here. So for calculating the value of AD, we will neglect RE. Now we'll come for output. So in an output, I already said there will be a 180 degree phase shift between input and output. So as it is an input, there will be an output. So which will be in a 180 degree phase shift. So here we have provided a positive and negative going signal. So here we get a negative and positive going signal. As well as here, we have provided a negative and positive going signal. So as it is a 180 degree phase shift, here we get a negative and positive. So this is an V0. So what is V0? V0 is equal to V01 minus V02. So the output voltage taken here, this output voltage is considered in between two collectors. So this output voltage is equal to V01 minus V02. So as these two things, what is V01? So V01 is positive and negative going signal. Okay. What is V02? So minus of negative and positive going signal. So this becomes what it becomes? So positive and negative going signal plus positive and negative going signal. So minus of minus will be a plus, and minus of plus will be a minus. Or simply we can say that if here it is an here if we get a 4, and here also we get a minus 4. So here we get a 4. So what is V01 minus V02? So V01 minus V02 becomes 4 minus of minus 4, that equal to 8. So in a differential mode operation, we see that there exists an output, but there will not be any signal flowing through RE. So the output will be maximum and the gain will be maximum, but RE will be eliminated in a differential mode operation because there is no signal flowing through RE. So now we will see in a common mode operation. Now what is meant by common mode operation? Common mode operation means we will provide same input for both the transistors. So what happens if we provide a same input for both the transistors? So if we provide same input, so VS is provided for both the transistors. That means here positive and negative. Here also there is a positive and negative going signal. So we will come for RE. So when we come for RE, there is no phase shift between base and emitter. So here also we get positive and negative going signal. And here we have provided a positive and negative going signal. So here there is also a positive and negative going signal. So these two signals flowing in the same direction. As these two signals are flowing in the same direction, they get adds up with each other. So positive and positive get adds up. Negative and negative gets adds up. That means there exists a signal flowing through RE. That means this RE provides a feedback. So these, as it is in common mode operation, there exists a common mode gain AC. But in a common mode operation, there is a signal flowing through RE which acts as a feedback. As there is a feedback, the AC value will be very less because feedback gain will be decreased. So whenever we provide a feedback, the gain will be decreased. So AC will be decreased. Now we'll come for output. So when we come for output, there is an 180 degrees phase shift between input and output. So it is an input, it is an output. So it is plus and minus. So as it is a 180 degrees phase shift, the output contains negative and plus. So here also we have provided a positive and negative. So the output is a 180. So here also we get negative and plus. What is V0? So V0 is equal to V01 minus V02. That means here we got both the signals are same. So when V0 is, that means here we get minus 2, here also we get minus 2. So what is V01 minus V02? Minus 2 minus of minus 2, that equal to 0 volts. So it says that in a common mode operation, there will be a signal flowing through RE which decreases the value of AC, but there will not be any output. There will not be any output. So for an ideal mode of operation, for an ideal differential amplifier, so I will say that whenever the input voltages are equal, the output will be 0 for an ideal case. So this indicates that in a differential mode operation, we provide this. So in a differential mode operation, we will provide two different input signals, but there will not be signal flowing through RE. As there is no signal flowing through RE, RE can be eliminated and there exists an output in a differential mode operation. But whereas in common mode operation, we provide same inputs, as we are providing the same inputs, there will be a signal flowing through RE. Whenever the signal flowing through RE, it acts as a feedback and the AC value will be decreased, and we see that there is no output in a common mode operation of differential amplifier. In the next class, we will see how the expressions of AD and AC. So the analysis of AD and AC. What is AD? Differential gain. What is AC? Common mode gain. Thank you.